never withdraw from. It just grows.
Yeah.
And it continues to grow. And it grows and grows. So I went through a period of time where I told you I was educated in DPS, Detroit Private School. So I was a little privileged growing up. God has always been good to me. I didn't have that story where my mom left me, my dad was on drugs. That's not my testimony. But I said, Lord, I want to live. And I want a testimony. He's like, you sure? I'm like, Lord, I want to live for you. And I want a testimony. He said, are you really sure? I'm like, yeah, I think I can handle it. So I had this wonderful job where I traveled all over the country. And in 2012, I got laid off. January 11, 2012, I got laid off. Never in life had I experienced lack. Never in life had I ever been without. And so God said, I chose you. And I'm like, okay, all right. January 11th, I'm cool. I'm like, okay, I lost my job. I got a little bit of money in the bank. I'm feeling a little severance. I'm good. January 12th, it hits me. I don't have a job. I've never not worked since I had graduated college. I have just bought a beautiful house. I'm driving a luxury car. And I have no job. God said, but I chose you because you said you wanted to serve me. You wanted to live for me. So sometimes to serve me and live for me, I got to break. I got to mold you. I got to bend you. I have to restore you. January 13th, it hits me that I don't know where the good money is going to come from. Because I'm so used to my job being my source and my resource. Not really having to deal with God being the true source. Now, did I trust God? Absolutely. Born and raised in church. I know God for myself. I've seen him be a healer in my family. I've seen him be a provider in my family. I've seen all this. But I've never had to really depend on him myself or what I need because everything was always provided. But on January the 13th, I literally laid on my face and began to worship God. Because I knew that I was at the most vulnerable point of my life. Because I can't turn to my mom for this. I can't turn to my father for this. I can only depend and trust on God. See, it's so easy for us to trust God when we're sitting on the top of the mountain.
Yes.
But when you're independent at valley, can you trust God with the same measure you trust
right.
him with when you have everything? See, we so many times look at God as being our resource instead of understanding that he is the source. And so sometimes God has to remove those things that you think satisfy and make you to really let you know I am the Alpha and the Omega. I am the beginning and the end. I am above and not beneath. I am everything. So I said, Lord, I trust you. He said, I'm going to break you. I'm going to take you down through there. Why? Because you have so many people that watch you. And they always see you happy, and you always talk to them, oh, I love God. You don't love God. But you've never been tested. And it's how you get through adversity and trials that determine your character. Because if you've never been tested, if you've never been through anything, then really, how can you relate? How can I sit and talk to a woman about maybe it's going to be all right, the Lord's going to provide, and he's never provided for me?
That's right.
So I had to go through some things. And everything that God showed me during that time frame, he manifested in my life. Things that I wanted to do, I wanted to do TV, I wanted to do radio. I didn't go to school for journalism or broadcast. I went to school for marketing management. But see, I said it's harvest time, right?
Yeah.
See, I've been sowing seeds my whole life. I've been practicing my whole life. I came out the womb running my mouth. I've been doing this my whole life. But the word of God says, that your gift will do what for you?
Make room.
It'll make room for you, and it'll put you in the presence of what? Grace in.
That's it.
Aren't you great? Aren't you great?
Uh-huh.
Aren't you great?
Yes.
Aren't you great? So I'm a manifestation of what the word of God is saying, because I'm in the presence of great men because of my gift. I didn't get here because I was selfish. I didn't get here because I didn't think of anybody else. I didn't get here because I chose to serve myself. I got here on the sweat of somebody else's work because I believed in another man's vision. encourage another person's vision. I believe in encouraging and supporting other people because when you do that, again, it adds to your life.
That's right.
So I said something about the bank of life. So now, I get laid off, and I said, I'm going to take the year to build Lola George. I'm going to work around the grind, and people will know this name across the state of Michigan. Little did I know that people will be able to know this name across the country because of the television platform that I had. I didn't see that part. We can't take God and put him in the box and say, God, this is what I want to do. No, God has so many great things in store for us. We just have to open up our minds and our hearts to receive the wonders of God. So now, I get back to work. I'm back in the working field again, doing both the life of Lola and working. I get laid off again. But this time, I ain't tripping. I'm like, because I've been through it.
Yes.
Now, I was working for a job in Nashville, Tennessee, but I was in India. So Nashville's unemployment is less than Michigan. Anybody know how much Michigan's unemployment is? Like 362?
A week.
A week? Yeah. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, let's talk about it. All right? I survived on $250 a week. Huh? When I tell you God, I take a little and make much, huh?
That's right.
And for people that know me, know the house that I have, the car, and it's like, how do you do that? I trust God. Okay, so let's go back to that bank of life that I've been talking about. See, that bank of life says that when you're low on your own, just go to this bank that you've been depositing in. Where am I eating? Don't worry about it. Your friend will call you. Say, girl, come on, let's go get something to eat. I want to go out of town. Don't worry about it, girl. I got two airline tickets. You want to go? Come on. See, that's that bank of life.
Uh-huh.
When you're good to people, life will be good to you. It's the evolution. What goes around comes around. Every seed that you sow, you must and you will reap that harvest. What I want to say to you today is I don't want to take up too much of your time. Last year you've been working and you worked towards something. And you didn't believe that it was going to come to pass because last year it didn't come to pass. But last year wasn't the year for it to come to pass. It was the year of you to put the work in. But how many of us know that our breakthrough is literally right around the corner? It is harvest time, sisters.
Right.
It is our time. The very door that you reached towards last year to open, God is going to miraculously open up those doors. And you're going to walk into your blessings. Only if you believe.
Come on now.
And faith not.
Yes.
God is the man that he cannot, he will not, he shall not. He will not lie. Every word that he utters upon you is true. Faith not on your vision. He gave it to you for you. Sometimes it's not for you to share with your friends because your friends can't understand what he's already showing
right.
you. So you try to say, well, you know what, next week I'm going to open up. What? They can't understand because God
right.
Don't get mad at them because they don't get what he gave you. You know why? Because he didn't give it to them. He gave it to you. It was for you. So as we continue to journey through 2016, just know that this is the year of harvest. Every good work that you've done today, we declare and decree that every victorious moment will be accomplished this year. But in order to do that, we have to continue to inspire others. As we inspire others, because in the inspiration of other people, we have the ability to encourage and bring the best out of other people. But once we've done that, we have to support their efforts. It doesn't make sense to inspire and then you drop off right there. Continue to support them because as you support them, you carry them through. You give
That's
them
right.
what they need because sometimes that journey can get long. It can get tedious. It can get hard. But it's always good to have that foundational support that a friend, a true friend, that will be able to stick with you and have your back.
That's right.
I love you ladies. I love you, George. Follow me on all Lola George, again, follow me on all social media, and I am Lola George. I am Lola George. You can also go to my website, and I am Lola George.
All right.
To speak.